It was 1611 when Hal Berridge, a boy playing Lady Macbeth, became feverish and died backstage before the premiere of the Tragedy of Macbeth. Stories say that Shakespeare had to dress in drag and step in for the part. However, it wasn't Shakespeare's reportedly terrible job at filling the role, but rather the large amount of bloody scenes and witchcraft that appalled King James I, who was so displeased that he banned the play from being performed for the next several years, and thus begins the list of tragedies that many theatergoers blame on, the Curse of Macbeth. The Curse of Macbeth centers on a play of the same name, first performed in 1611 at the Globe Theatre. It was written around 1606 by the famous playwright Shakespeare. The main ideas of the play are power and greed. Much like the Bloody Mary superstition, the curse states that you cannot say Macbeth in a theatre unless it is in your script, though some say that you cannot say it at all, and those who produce the play are plagued with bad luck. When referring to the play, those who believe in the superstition use its nicknames: the Scottish play, talking about the setting, the Bard's play, because Shakespeare wrote it, or just the play. Unfortunately, the play, which must not be named, is unpopular and a mouthful, and therefore is not used. There are many theories as to why the play is so unlucky. One is that in the play, real witches' spells are recast. King James believed this and was seen as credible, as he'd already authored a book on witchcraft and found the spells too authentic. Another is that the Hecate scene was frequently cut out, and therefore Hecate was angered and cursed the play. Others say that the prop master stole a cauldron from a witch coven, or that Shakespeare stole quotes from an actual witch coven, and the witches cursed the play in revenge. Some even say that Shakespeare used the curse in the script to actually curse the play, so he could be the only one to direct it. The list of large accidents connected to Macbeth is long. In 1672, in Amsterdam, the actor playing Macbeth accidentally used a real dagger for the blunted stage dagger and killed the actor playing Duncan on stage. During a London revival of Macbeth in 1703, where they used a light-hearted musical version of the play, England was hit with one of the most violent storms in its history. Female Lady Macbeths have been hit hard by the curse as well. In 1775, Sarah Siddons was nearly attacked by an audience. Sybil Thorndike was almost strangled by a fellow actor in 1926. In 1948, Diana Wynard decided to play the sleepwalking scene with her eyes closed and sleepwalked right off the stage, falling 15 feet, though she still finished the scene. In the mid-1800s, two rival actors staged competing productions so that on May 10, 1849, they were both playing Macbeth in New York. An audience of fans of one actor, Edwin Forrest, threw fruit and chairs at the rival, William Charles Macready, during his show at the Astor Place Opera House, starting a riot. The militia was called in on and fired on the crowd, killing 20 and wounding over 30 people. During the first modern dress production at the Royal Court Theatre in London in 1928, a large set collapsed, seriously injuring some cast members. In a 1937 production, a heavy counterweight crashed to the stage, missing Laurence Olivier, who played Macbeth, by near inches. In a 1942 staging with John Geigler as Macbeth, three actors, two witches and Duncan, died and the set designer committed suicide. In a Thursday night performance in 1947, Harold Norman was stabbed during the final sword fight and died of his wounds. In a 1953 outdoor show in Bermuda, a gust of wind blew smoke and flames into the audience. Charlton Heston, who was playing Macbeth, suffered severe burns on his groin and leg because his tights had been soaked in kerosene, though some reports say that the burns were caused by friction while riding a horse bareback during a scene. In 1970, Rip Torn's production was halted by an actor strike, and in 1971, David Leary's Run suffered two fires and seven robberies. In 1970 Run, Roman Polanski made a film version. A camera operator was nearly killed in an accident on the first day of filming, and in 2001, during a production by the Cambridge Shakespeare Company, Macduff injured his back, Lady Macbeth hurt her head, Ross broke a toe, and two cedar trees from Burnham Wood fell and destroyed the set. There are, however, several ways that you can save yourself from the curse. If you say Macbeth in a theater, be sure to spin three times, spit or swear over your left shoulder, and or recite a relevant line from another Shakespeare play, such as "Angels and ministers of grace defend us," from Hamlet, Scene 1, Act 4. Another way is to go outside, spin three times, brush yourself off, and say Macbeth three times before going back inside. Some groups have to invite you back in, so if you sage frequently, you could be left outside for a long time. To this date, people still believe in the Macbeth curse, and accidents correlating to Macbeth continue to occur. But Macbeth is a popular play, and accidents are not uncommon to theater. So, is it a case of correlation is not causation, or is the curse a reality? We may never know, but it continues to be a subject of fascination.